gas can do for us.
So why is there so little progress on that front? There is no progress. I mean, there is no progress. We are going to begin to produce oil. It will come with gas, and we are going to reinject the gas. And you know, this subject, this is always a passion pet subject for me, so I have to say, because like you, I think that the gas is really not the magic wand, but the provider of opportunity.
Yeah.
What is government's plan for the gas?
First and foremost, the gas enables us to take our place as the leading producer of power in the West African sub-region. You know, we have signed on to the West African Power Pool. That allows us to share power, you know, with countries that have a deficit in power. Ghana used to be a leading exporter of power to Togo, Benin, and so on and so forth, when our almighty Akosombo, was the main supplier, generator of energy. Unfortunately, we lost it because we didn't put in enough capacity over the years while our demand was growing. We thought that Akosombo was going to last us for God knows how long. And we found ourselves, caught out. But governments have learned since then. The previous NDC government put in a lot of investment in the Abwaze thermal plants and all that. Yeah. The previous government came and worked on the various thermal plants in the thermal area. So we have increased capacities considerably. There are a lot of independent power producers coming with offers to build thermal plants. Now, all these thermal plants, you know, would be more efficient and have a lower cost of production if they are run on gas than if they are run on crude, light crude oil.
Right.
And so we have the West African gas pipeline. Unfortunately, there isn't sufficient gas coming through it.
What we 20 have, years late.
What we have now is free flow gas, which is not sufficient to feed. We have agreements with Nigeria, actually, that in July, compressed gas would come through. Unfortunately, we are told that there's a delay, some technical issues and all that. But we have our own gas potential. And I think that from some of the exploration...
Only potential. Still just potential.
Yeah, still... Well, we know exactly what is available in the Jubilee field. They're going to do the appraisal of the other fields around, and we'll know exactly what is possible.
Who is doing this?
But there are other exploratory blocks next door that have been seen to contain more gas than oil. And so how to harness all this gas and use it to supply our power generation so that we can sell power on to other countries, I think, will be very critical. But the most important is the industry that we can set up using gas. And already, as you are aware, we've signed a memorandum of understanding with an Indian company to set up a fertilizer plant to produce urea.
But
ammonia.
You have no gas, Mr. Mahama. You have no.
We'll
gas
have gas here. By next year.
So that's when it'll hopefully all of this will begin.
Some technical agreements are being signed that would tap the gas from deep water to shallow, and then we'll take it from there and bring it onshore. And then we'll set up a processing plant, you know, and then build pipelines to Abwaze and to Efaso.
The Ghana government will fund this sort of thing?
There's money available.
To build the infrastructure for gas?
No, there's a lineup of financiers waiting to give money for
this. So who will we partner? I mean, why is that so difficult? I mean, I'm quite curious. I mean, you take me back
to the... A partnership is being formed as I speak.
A
partnership is being formed as I speak.
So it's a private people
partnership? It's going to be a public-private partnership. Okay. Yeah, and then that company is going to raise the financing. And indeed, their financiers lined up. I spoke to, I don't need to mention names, but I've met at least two groups that are willing to give the money to finance the
Chinese, perhaps? Gas. Let's talk about the Chinese. Let's talk about the Chinese
actually,
and the oil
not
and
Chinese,
gas industry.
Multilateral. Okay. Multilateral partners.
What about the Chinese? Yeah. Where do the Chinese fit into our plans for oil and gas? Everywhere you turn, there's a story about the Chinese. Can you tell us, as Vice President said, where does Ghana intend to partner with Chinese to develop its oil and gas resources?
Let me tell you about the geopolitics of oil. You know, China is growing very fast, and it requires energy to be able to fuel that growth. And oil forms a key factor. And so it's not only in Africa. If you go to Qatar, you go to Iraq, you go to Iran and other places, China is buying blocks and wells in order that they can guarantee supplies to their country.
Right.
It's the same. America has the same interest.
Indeed.
I mean, and I don't begrudge any country to have an interest in securing a commodity that will ensure the stability of their economy.
Yeah.
And so all the ExxonMobils and everything trying to get stakes in, you know, various blocks, it's to guarantee supplies to their own economies. And so I don't...
But what about Ghana? What do we want from that? I mean,
for Ghana, the overriding factor should be our national interest. Who gives us a better offer in respect?
And what is that? I mean, without pressing you too much on that, so I'm quite curious. I mean, because we've spent a year listening to disputes, things about...
there will be no dispute.
Well, I mean, in a sense, I mean, Cosmos Energy has not necessarily been the company that has had the best of relationships in the last year, if you like, with the government. I mean, it is obvious there are challenges. And I am keen to hear your view on where you think things are going. I mean, you might not have the detail or not want to discuss that, but I would like to know what is our national interest and how do we intend to deal with this?
I'll be just a bit broad because right now there are some critical decisions being taken and some discussions going on. And I won't want to preempt or to disclose, you know, what I know in that domain. Yeah. But I think that part of the problem has been the interpretation of the existing law. And that's why we need to bring this petroleum bill in as quickly as possible.
It's not this government behaving like new king, new law.
No, the existing law has not been very clear. For instance, the issue to do with Cosmos. If you go to the PNDC law, you know, that governed the petroleum sector, it says that a partner in an agreement cannot transfer part or all of his shares to another party without the consent of the secretary. At that time, it used to be PNDC secretary, but that means the minister. Yeah. You understand? Now, one of the questions somebody will ask is, at what point should the consent be given? Can they go and negotiate and come for consent? Or must they come and even seek consent to go and negotiate for the sale of the shares? You know, there are a lot of gray areas in the previous legislation, which will be cured when this new petroleum bill is passed. But I think that there were some issues that came up, you know, disagreements between Cosmos and GMPC and the ministry, which are issues the president has taken up. And I think that in the next, in a very short while, the issues will be resolved. Cosmos want to sell, and I think that they are free to sell and leave. The issue is about what the new partnership will be. And I think there are just a few issues that will be resolved soon.
Yeah.